Light mapping is a way of lighting objects to make them look highly realistic, or for that matter, highly stylized. For static objects in particular, those that aren't moving, the idea is to pre-compute shadows, reflected light, and any other lighting effects desired. For example, you can see in this scene that the smaller cube has a subtle realistic shadow effect on the larger one. This type of effect is difficult to compute at interactive rates. This is how the process works. First, here's a scene without any lighting applied. Every surface is assigned an additional texture called a light map. This extra texture will be used to capture the light's effect. Some offline process is done to the illumination in the scene. As much time as desired can then be spent determining how much light reaches each pixel on each surface. The results are stored in the light map. The light map is a mosaic texture, holding many different surfaces' illumination calculations. For example, the lower left corner of this light map is for the ground plane. You can see the two shadows of the cubes laying on it. When the objects are displayed, the fragment shader takes the object's color texture and multiplies it by the corresponding light map texture. This gives the surface an illuminated look. Here's the final result. Note that it's the same or darker than the original image without illumination. This is why light maps are sometimes half-jokingly called dark maps, since they lessen the overall light. In theory, you could bake the lighting into each color texture itself instead of using a separate light map texture. While possible, this can quickly get expensive. One major advantage of light maps is that they can have a much lower resolution than the texture on the surface itself, and can be stored in a single color channel instead of three. Rather than storing six high-resolution textures per cube in the scene, each with the lighting baked in, just one texture and six small light maps are stored for each.